capturing the light and energy of the sun has been the holy grail of scientists for centuries. In the field of modern solar energy, Professor Michael Gretzel is a renowned pioneer. But it wasn't always that way. For 30 years, his colleagues thought he was crazy.
It's been a rough start and also a rough ride, especially in the beginning. People were skeptical and we went against the prevailing opinion.
When Professor Gretzel started out, solar technology was based on silicon panels. But he had other ideas. For him, the answer was in the colors of the natural world.
I always feel very happy, surrounded by green trees in my orchard. And I love nature. I was inspired by the natural system.
Nature has its own way of converting sunlight to energy through the process of photosynthesis. Gretzel started researching how he could imitate that process to create a source of sustainable energy.
I was passionate about finding systems that would produce electricity from light by not exactly imitating natural photosynthetic systems, but taking the most important cues from the photosynthetic system.
His pioneering work was based on a simple principle. The pigment that gives every plant its color is also the chemical that converts sunlight to energy during photosynthesis. Based on these color pigments, Gretzel created his own dyes. Today, they help make the Gretzel dye-sensitized cells, and they work like this. Dip a piece of conductive glass coated in titanium dioxide into mashed-up raspberries. The resulting pink pigment makes a great anode. To create the cathode, simply scribble a layer of graphite across a second piece of glass. Add a couple of drops of iodine to complete the circuit. Expose it to light to represent the sun. Excited by the sunlight, the electrons then flow out as an electrical current. And there you have it, a fan powered by a raspberry juice solar cell. All over our cities, Gretzel saw millions of meters of glass reaching to the heavens. If all this glass were coated in transparent Gretzel cells, it could help power those buildings. But back in the early 90s, the efficiency of his solar cells was poor, and no one was prepared to back him.
Our funding dried up, nobody believed in it anymore, but I was convinced. And sometimes a scientist has to be very persistent in his approach.
But in 1994, something happened that turned Gretzel's life and his work around.
That's when Toby came in.
I'm Toby Meyer. I am now CEO of Solarnix. Before that, I was doing my PhD work in Professor Gretzel's lab.
Ah, bonsoir, Professor.
Bonsoir.
Working side by side with Toby, Gretzel was faced with the challenge of improving the performance of the solar cells. And they still had to deal with the skepticism that often comes with the promises of new materials.
It was a total skepticism at the beginning, that this ever would be a solar cell that can be useful. People had an expectation that now this new thing will come out quickly in a very fast and elegant way. That was kind of the misconception.
So, to win people over, the partners improved the efficiency of the synthetic dye, enabling them to deliver real products.
What you see here is a table that's fit with dye solar cells and that charges a phone or any electronic device just by picking up the daylight. And when you need, you can charge up the phone with the table for free.
Gretzel's work began 40 years ago with a simple idea and a lot of ambition in his sunlit orchard. Today, the coloured windows in the Swiss Convention Centre, covered in a thin film of Gretzel cells, are a celebration of his vision and determination. And if their efficiency can be increased, as they hope, then maybe one day they'll help to power whole cities. This may be a long way off, but Gretzel will keep striving.
And you know, learning for a scientist, that is the opium. It's our opium. Understanding and learning should never finish. So, merci beaucoup. Yes, voilà.